Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to start our new series on VBA. So today, I would like to give you an introduction to what Visual Basic for Applications is, and in the upcoming weeks, give you some more examples of how to use VBA for some specific tasks within Microsoft Excel. So what is VBA? VBA is just short for Visual Basic for Applications. VBA is the coding language that Microsoft Excel uses. In order to use this language, you would create something in Excel called a macro. A macro allows you to do a repetitive task over and over and over again without having to click on separate buttons. So it will automate a task and just do it for you. A macro can also do some more sophisticated tasks that you can't necessarily do easily inside of Microsoft Excel. And finally, a macro will also allow you to manipulate other Microsoft Office applications, such as Word, Outlook, Microsoft Access, even a little notepad file or a text file could be manipulated using Visual Basic for Applications. So when someone says Visual Basic for Applications, that means the code behind the macro. The macro is just a generic word for automating a task, and VBA is the code behind the macro. So today we are going to go over how to create a macro, and then we will look at some aspects of the VBA window, and then I will just give you a few examples of commonly used coding words that you will need to know for upcoming lessons. So to begin, I'm just going to open up Microsoft Excel and click here for a blank workbook. Once inside a new workbook, I want to introduce you to the View ribbon. There's many things on the View ribbon, but in particular today, we are interested in the Macros group over here. This button under Macros has a list that says View Macros or Record Macro. If you already have a macro in your spreadsheet, you can go to View Macros and it will show you a list of them. However, we do not have a macro in the spreadsheet yet, so we are going to have to go to Record Macro in order to put our first macro inside of this workbook. But one thing that you need to know is we need to go to File, Save As, and I'm going to hit Browse. And I want to show you the results in this pull down box right here. If I want a workbook that has a macro in it, I have to save it as an XLSM. It's my second option down. And I can save this macro as VBA Introduction and just hit Save. And then when I look up here, I can see that this is being saved as an XLSM, which is exactly what I want because I need that kind of file type in order to be able to run macros inside of my Excel workbook. So let's just do a simple task inside of Excel. I'm going to pull down this menu and hit Record Macro. I'm going to be asked for a macro name. I'm going to call this one Test Macro, and I'm going to say OK. Now I'm going to click on B2, I'm going to right click, go to Format Cells, go to Border, and put an outline on this cell and say OK. And then I'm going to go back to Macros and do Stop Recording. So if I click off that cell, I can see that I put a big border on cell B2. Now if I click on a plain cell and I use my Format Painter and I click back on B2, you will see B2 has been restored to its original formatting. But if I go back to View, and I pull down on macros, and I go to View Macros, I will see the macro that I just created in that list. If I hit Run, I will see that cell B2 has now had a border put around it, just like I wanted that macro to do. So I could do that over and over again. Instead of right-clicking and going to Format, I could just automatically have cell B2 get a border put around it every time I run this macro here in the macro list. Now, what did that macro do behind the scenes? If I click down on the Macros button and I go to View Macros, I have Test Macro here. So when I double click on it or I hit the Run button, this macro will run. But if I hit Edit, this is where it gets really fun. The Visual Basic for Application window will be launched. And you can look through my text. You can see right here, Range B2. That means cell B2 has been selected. And all of these borders have been applied to that cell. So that's how I got the dark border around cell B2. We're going to go into how to modify this macro a little bit more in future lessons. But for now, we're going to go over the VBA window. This whole window is called the Visual Basic for Applications window. You can see that up here across the top bar. I have a couple things in here. I have this window right here, which allows me to write my code. I have an immediate window down here, which we will go over in future lessons, but basically this immediate window is really powerful. It lets me track the value of my variables when I have a lot of complicated code. And it also lets me run code that's not inside of my macro on the side. And if I look over here to the left, I have what's called the Project Explorer. Now I can write code in a lot of different places inside of my workbook. Right now, macros are stored in a module. And in this case, they're stored in module 1. If I double click on sheet 1, you will see that my macro is not here to be found. But if I go back to module 1 and I double click, I can now see test macro. And all of my macros for this workbook are going to be in this pull down box right here. Right now I only have one macro, but if I were to record another one, I would be able to see that right here. I can also write code inside of the workbook that I'm using right now. So if I double click here, I have a pull down box right here, and I have two options in here, general and workbook. Under general, I'm going to write code that I can use throughout my workbook. But if I select workbook over here to the right, there are a lot of things that happen within a workbook. These are called events. I can do an event after I save my workbook. I can do an event when I open my workbook. I can do an event when I change a sheet. I can do an event when I activate a window or deactivate a window. So you can see there are a lot of different events that you would normally use within a workbook that are listed here where you could write code for those. But on workbook open, I could actually have a message box that says you have opened this workbook. Every time you open this workbook, that would be kind of annoying, but there are cases when you want to run code right when a workbook has been opened. So this is exactly where you would do it. So in review for the VBA window, you have the Project Explorer over here, which allows me to write code for an event inside the workbook, or I can double click on the module and you can see all of the macros that I've created in this list. And then I also have the code window, which is where I will write my code. And then I have the immediate window, which will allow me to track variables and write other code. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. So just a few words I want you to be aware of that we'll definitely go over again next week. There's this word called dim, and what dim does is it allows me to create a variable inside of Visual Basic for Applications. So if I put dim str name as string, I now have a variable called str name that I will be able to manipulate throughout my code. And also, while I'm manipulating it throughout my code, I can keep track of what the value of that variable is using the immediate window down here. So dim is short for dimension, and it means I'm going to declare a variable within inside Visual Basic for Applications. I also want you to look at this word sub up here and these two parentheses right here. This means there is a routine that is going to run. So in this case, our routine is called test macro. And I know test macro is a routine because it's surrounded by the word sub and the double parentheses right here. If I go back to clicking on this workbook, you will see that there is a sub called workbook underscore open because it has a sub in front of it and two parentheses on the other side of it. So these are both different subroutines that you can run inside of VBA. See how this code turns green and it's got a single apostrophe in front of it? This is how you comment out codes that you don't want Visual Basic to run, but you want to keep some notes inside of your code. When you create a macro, Excel does this for you automatically, a test macro, macro. But this is in green because it has the apostrophe right in front of it. So this is just text that when you run the code, VBA will ignore. Sometimes when Excel writes code, it writes way more code than you actually need. And the reason that happened in this case is because when I opened the format cell box, it wrote code for the left border, the bottom border, the right border, the top border, and the diagonal borders because it wanted to make sure it got all the borders correct. In reality, the only thing I really want to change is this weight for my borders. And this is my left border. I can actually get rid of all of this code right here and just leave the weight because that's what I'm changing. And I don't really need to put none for these diagonal borders either because I'm not really changing the diagonal borders at all. So if I save that up here on the toolbar and I go back to Excel, I'm going to use that format painter again to set my cell back to its original value. And I'm going to go back to view, go to macros, view macros, and run this one again. And you will see that it did in fact put the dark borders in. So before we go today, I thought it would be really interesting to show you just one macro change. What if instead of going to B2, I wanted to be able to put this border around whatever cell I was on currently? What would I do then? If I hit the macro button, I'm going to go edit my macro. Right here, you can see range B2.select. That's how I picked cell B2. I'm just going to write application.activeCell. I can already see it in the list. Let me give you a shortcut. If I select it and then hit a period, it will type the whole name in for me. And then I'm going to type the word select. But let me show you something right here. I try to type in lowercase because when I click off my line, watch the S in select. It will be capitalized automatically. And I use that as a test to whether or not I have entered my code correctly. Because if it does capitalize, that means VBA recognized the code that I typed in. So it's just a good habit to get into. Type in lowercase and then let Excel change the case for you. And then you'll know if your code has been entered correctly. So let's go back to Excel. And now I'm going to click on any cell, go to view, go to macros, and hit run. When I click off that cell, I will see that that cell received borders. And now I'm going to do the same thing again. And I will see that that cell received borders. So now, instead of going to a specific cell, I can put borders on whatever cell I'm currently on. This is a very simple macro, but we will get into more complicated ones as the weeks go on. So in review today, we defined what is VBA and what is a macro. We looked at the view ribbon and the macros group. We looked at different aspects of the VBA window. And we went over the coding words sub and dim and how to comment out your code. And also, don't forget the tip to train yourself to write in lowercase so that Excel will correct the text for you. Hopefully you learned something new about VBA today, and you'll join us again next week when we get into writing actual macros for commonly used tasks within Excel. See you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.